because it's actually for me the biggest question. Okay, so one of the challenges I face is that I think all of us that are facing a lot of disruption, because the challenge is the concept of work for life, the concept of even what means a job and what means to have an education. It's going to be completely disrupted in the next 5 to 10 years. It's already being, and most of the universities are not preparing students for that. Most of the universities have no digital education, no much less AI education. And at the end of the day, this is already mainstream. The financial industry depends on AI for all the transactions. I think 90% of the transactions in the financial industry are done by machines and algorithms. And if you go to wealth, it's as well from crypto to blockchain to anything. It's all about technology. But most of the people don't even understand it. So I just want to touch this area purely from your experience working with wealthy individuals, with wealth organizations, and as well non-for-profits and in the United Nations. What is the area that you do? I understood from your foundation, you're more focused on social good, but do you do as well this? And holistically, how can we tackle this? Because that's the biggest elephant in the room for our civilization. I'm not even talking about the future that comes out of this, but purely the disruption that is coming from this. Because effectively, there's a lot of wealth being created, but as well, a lot of disruption being created. And the perception is becoming completely blurred.
Yeah, again, it's also a very big question to answer. It's not an easy one. I would say if we had to simplify, if we had to start with a simple explanation, right? Not simplify the answer, but to start with a simple explanation, we can probably use two words, right? Financial literacy and technological literacy. And then we need to start from there. So I think the challenge we have, if you look at financial literacy, is that we have actually a significant amount of financial literacy across the world. When I say that, you know, and we talk about it, viewers in their minds, the first picture that comes to their mind, they might be thinking third world countries, you know, developing nations. Unfortunately, this cuts across the world. It includes our mature economies as well. So if you take, you know, like the US, for example, US actually has a very high financial literacy, financial illiteracy rate across generations, reported in so many surveys and research studies done by both government as well as non-governmental organizations in that market. But I just use US as an example, right? It's across the board in the UK, in Europe, in Australia, even in Singapore. And we're talking about the younger generation, even the Zoomers or the Gen Zers, millennials, they actually fall into that financial illiteracy trap. And coming to technological literacy, that's probably the generation that is far more literate technologically / digitally as compared to Gen X and the boomers, right? So it's a bit of the reverse situation there. And that's where we have to address technological illiteracy with the Gen X and the boomer generation. And it's about, I guess, having activities, programs, you know, even at a grassroots level that allows these people to have access to just explanations, descriptions, you know, that allow them to become literate, right? So they get a sense of the basics and then they can move from there. Then the challenge with the information is we are in an age whereby there are so many conduits, so many channels of information. A lot of that information can also be biased, inaccurate. So because they are receiving information from a variety of sources, some of those sources may not be reliable, but because that's how they consume, right? So if you take example of the Zoomer or the Gen Z generation and how they are currently learning financial concepts, they learn from TikTok, they learn from YouTube, right? So you've got people who actually don't know what they're talking about. They're probably, some of them are frauds and scammers, giving them financial advice / education, right? And that's something that doesn't help the individual to become really financial literate, and they end up actually taking that advice making the wrong decisions, and they then drop out of, I guess, the financial security journey, right? Because they've taken a step back. And likewise, even with the technological literacy, a lot of what we learn about new tech comes through new tech, right? So what are the so-called, I won't say new tech, but what are the tech platforms that we are receiving information from? And again, there are a fair amount of inaccuracies and also in unreliable information. So people are not really getting the correct picture for them to actually have a solid understanding. And then from there itself, they end up making all the wrong decisions, right? Especially when you also have the middle ground where finance and technology comes together. And that's where we're talking about things like making lots of quick money through digital assets, which may or may not be assets, but let's say maybe just cryptocurrency, right? So there's a lot of punters in that space because they got the financial literacy and the technological literacy from the sources, which then tells them, you know, you can make money. And yes, I'm not saying that they don't. Yes, they do, but it's, I guess, a roller coaster ride. So they might make today, they might lose tomorrow, they might make again the next day and then lose again, you know, the day after. That does not create financial security for those individuals on a long-term basis. So if they were trying to become, I guess, financially secure and independent over time, it's just going to take them, it might actually cause them to take several steps back. So I think that's another hole between financial literacy and technological literacy that we need to plug, right? So it's financial illiteracy, technological literacy, and then the in-between.
I think a fantastic summary, and I appreciate it. See, you answered actually very well and actually very good point. And these are actually probably the biggest topics of our times.